Our nodes now have a style and our ports can be connected with each other. That pretty much means most of our nodes are done. However, there is one other feature in the final dialog system which involves groups. Groups are simply a way for you to group your nodes. We'll be using it to make it easier to organize and select a starting dialog. The way we'll be adding groups is through the contextual menu, much like our nodes. So let's go ahead to our GraphView script and add a new manipulator, in which I'll pass in a method we'll create named CreateGroupContextualMenu. Inside this method, we'll just paste in the same code as our CreateNodeContextualMenu method. Of course, we can remove our action title here and type in addGroup. And instead of calling CreateNode, we'll call a new method named CreateGroup. In this method, we'll be accepting a title and a position. So let's swap our dialog type with the name of the group instead, which will be dialog group. To create a group, we will need to create a variable of type group, which is a GraphView class. I'll name it group and call its constructor. To update the name of the group, we update its title variable, to which we'll be sending in our title parameter. We will also set its position using the setPosition method. When that's done, simply return the group and make sure to swap the graph element return type to group instead. If we save and go to Unity, we shall now be able to add in a new group. The cool thing about this is that we can now place our nodes inside of this group by dragging them into it, and remove them by pressing Shift and then dragging them out. The GraphView class also provides us with some cool callbacks when we do these actions, that we'll be using later on.